I think it was very interesting to hear Henry earlier when he was talking about his discussions with Marco and Gillian and talked about it as grumbling. I think really, for me, when I was listening to Philip, that sort of echoed the positioning that Philip was talking about. You know, parish councils having so much energy, but not really knowing where to take it. And I think that's certainly my experience of parish councils when I've worked with them through the parish council liaison committee. So it's that sense of really wanting to be engaged, but not quite sure where their foothold is in what, how they deliver that. I think the Localism Act has been hailed as a sort of opening up lots of opportunities for councils and for voluntary sector, community sector and parish councils. But really what it has done, the main provision, is offer a community right to bid. And you heard Philip talking earlier about how actually that community right to bid can actually be quite restrictive in what it does, because what it actually does is place you in a procurement process with lots of other people who might want to bid for the same services. So it isn't perhaps the panacea that we want, but nonetheless, I think what's really important about the Localism Act for me is that it demonstrates that provision at the local level is really going to be the way forward, both for us as a unitary council and for you as parish councils. So one of the things I looked at when I was going to address you here about the Localism Act was looking at some of the ways in which parish councils have helped deliver services locally in other places. And there are, I suppose for you, so many ideas been presented this morning that it's hard for you to know where to begin. But here are some examples, really, of where parish councils have helped deliver in the local delivery of services. So we've had the control of markets, for example, maintenance of highway verges, open spaces, footways and footpaths, allotments, tree preservation orders, street naming, bus and rail passes, and licensing of taxis and street trading. But that's... Well, clearly, that's not intended to be a restrictive list. There are lots of other services that parishes may choose or want to help deliver. But what you have got now is the general power of competence, which, of course, makes it more flexible in what you can do. So you're not certainly not restricted to those sort of very small areas anymore. But I think the intention behind the Localism Act is that it's really opened up, and the idea of today is to really generate some ideas about where you would like to take yourself. And, of course, we heard from Philip that the ideas can be hugely, hugely much wider than the delivery of those small services. But for you as parish councils, I suppose, it's where do you start? Where is your beginnings? And how, once you've decided what you wanted to do, where do you move forward? So we've put some questions on your table, which are intended to provoke that debate, really, looking at what, if the localism has opened up all those opportunities for you, where do you begin and how do you move forward with those ideas? So I'm going to leave those with you now. You've got 20 to 25 minutes, and then Richard will come up and facilitate some of the responses to those questions. Thank you.